Completed in 1940 at Newport News Shipbuilding in Newport News, Virginia, the SS America was a 722-foot, 35,000-ton displacement ocean liner. Powered by four double-reduction-geared steam turbines, she was capable of carrying 1,200 passengers. Sponsored by First Lady Eleanor Roosevelt, the America was launched on August 31, 1939. From 1940 to 1941, she sailed as the flagship of the United States line. As war in Europe spread, it became inevitable that the United States would get involved in some capacity, and on May 28, 1941, the America was called into service by the Navy as a troop transport. She sailed to Norfolk and, after conversion, was renamed USS West Point. The conversion by the Navy increased her passenger capacity to over 7,500, and she spent the better part of the next 5 years ferrying troops and refugees to and from locations all over the globe. This work earned her numerous service and campaign medals. Following World War II, she was transferred back to civilian service and her name was changed back to SS America. She sailed various transatlantic routes until 1964, when she returned to Newport News to be scrapped. Before that could happen, America was purchased by the Greek Chandris Group and renamed Australis. Her passenger capacity was increased to over 2,200 and she began to regularly sail an emigrant route from Southampton, England to Australia and New Zealand. This continued for 13 years until she was laid up at Damaru, New Zealand in December of 1977. Australis was purchased by the New York-based Venture Cruises in 1978 and renamed America. Her first cruise under this ownership was disastrous, as her refit had been hastily performed and was not complete by the time she left port. Conditions aboard were so bad that a group of passengers forced the captain to turn back before America could pass out of sight of the Statue of Liberty. The rest of her career with Venture Cruises went just as poorly, as she was impounded for non-payment of debts and miserably failed an inspection by the U.S. Public Health Service. In late 1978, the U.S. District Court ordered America to be sold at auction. America was once again purchased by Chandris and this time renamed Adelis. Chandris removed her forward funnel as part of a plan to modernize her silhouette that never saw completion. Adelis served in a variety of roles for Chandris for the next year before being laid up again in September of 1979. America languished for the next decade and a half, changing hands and names a number of times. Finally, in 1993, she was sold yet again and plans were made to tow her to Phuket, Thailand, where she would become a floating luxury hotel. Renamed the American Star, she was prepared for transoceanic towing and left Greece in December of 1993 behind a Ukrainian tug. Only a few weeks into the three-month operation, the tow lines between American Star and the tug were broken in a thunderstorm. Attempts to reattach them failed, and on January 17, 1993, the crew aboard her were rescued by helicopter, leaving the once proud vessel adrift in the Atlantic. The next day she ran aground off of the western coast of Fuerteventura, one of the Canary Islands. Within 48 hours of her grounding, America's hull broke in two just aft of her second funnel. In July 1994 she was declared a total loss, and 2 years later her stern collapsed into the sea. The bow section held on quite a while longer, gradually leaning and collapsing year by year. The haunting sight of the gigantic vessel slowly rusting away above the waterline made for a popular tourist attraction and photo opportunity. In April 2007, the bow finally gave way completely and fell into the sea, bringing the story of the SS America to a sad end.